Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Meadowbrook United Church's first virtual Christmas concert, dubbed Love Came Down. This evening, we share with you gifts in the form of music, dance, song, sign language, and the spoken word. These gifts are presented by our church's choirs, as well as friends of Meadowbrook who have journeyed with us faithfully. So sit back, relax, and enjoy as we embark on this journey together. As we prepare to partake in this concert, let us go to God in prayer. Sovereign God, we give you thanks for your love. Your love as shown through your Son, Jesus Christ. Your love that we are told in Scripture that is renewed every morning because your faithfulness abounds to us. Your love that knows no end. So even as we reflect on the gift of your love, may we remember to share this love, not just at Christmas, but at all times. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We continue our program with our first musical item, Ring the Bells by Mrs. Yvonne Miller. And that will be followed by Christmas Hallelujah, presented by Floyd Casanova and Joel Dewey. After which we will reinvite Mrs. Yvonne Miller to share with us the song, Would You Be Lost in Bethlehem? Hereafter, the program will flow unannounced.
Ring the bells, ring the bells, let the whole world know. Christ was born in Bethlehem many years ago. Born to die that man might live, came to earth, new life to give. Born of Mary, born so low, many years ago. God the Father gave his Son, gave his own beloved one, to this wicked, sinful earth, to bring mankind his love, new birth. Ring the bells, ring the bells, let the whole world know. Christ was born in Bethlehem many years ago. God the Father gave his Son, gave his own beloved one, to this wicked, sinful earth, to bring mankind his love, new birth. Ring the bells, oh, ring the bells. this morning. Would you be mindful of the star that shone above? Would you be looking for the babe within a manger? Would you be conscious of the King whose name is love? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? And would that quiet little town seem cold and bare? Would you believe that God had come? And would you find in Him your home? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem if you were there? If you should see the wise men three and humble shepherds, would you believe with them and join the heavenly quest? If they should ask where Christ was born, how would you answer? Would you be heedless of this coming like the rest? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? And would that quiet little town seem cold and bare? Would you believe that God had come? And would you make for Him your home? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem if you were there? Haste until at last you found Him. What would you say when you had found the Christ so sweet? Would you be satisfied to praise Him and adore Him? Or would you in homage at His blessed feet? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem? And would that quiet little town seem cold and bare? Would you believe that God had come? And would you find in Him your home? Would you feel lost in Bethlehem if you
But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. Galatians 4, verses 4 and 5. This is the Christmas story, the story of a miracle. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Rejoice, for God so loved the lowest and the highest, the rich and the poor, male and female, black and white, every one of us. What a beautiful night.
What a beautiful night. What a wonderful night. Heaven touched earth in all its splendor and glory. What a beautiful night. What a wonderful night. Tell to all the world the Christmas story. God loved everyone. He gave his only Son,
that we might be like become with every people before him.
What a beautiful night. What a wonderful night. Let us our voices raise in a song of grateful praise. Let us honor the King of Kings.
Oh, what a beautiful night.
Oh, what a beautiful night.
Oh, what a wonderful night.
Oh, what a wonderful night.
Unto us a child is born.
Isaiah 7, verse 14 reads, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us." Jesus came to us when we needed a Savior, and he makes all things new. God's loving presence with us is the greatest gift of all. Let's ponder the profound privilege of being connected to the Creator of the universe. Let every heart rejoice, for the kingdom of God is within you. Our Emmanuel has come.
Shine in the heavens above.
He will bring us joy.
He will bring us joy.
His tiny little stranger.
Tiny little stranger. For he comes to fill God's world with peace and love.
Glory,
glory, glory,
glory,
glory,
glory.
Peace to all on earth.
Angels love God.
Kneel before him.
Now I kneel before him.
Now come and greet that child who is born tonight.
Gather round and sing.
Come worship and adore him.
Worship and adore him.
For he comes to fill God's world with hope and love.
Glory,
glory, glory,
glory,
glory.
All the rulers in the world, why he to save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved, there would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had so far, and as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him, with all the rulers in the world? Why he? Inside this table filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to say. What angels have to say, but this is such a strange way, such a strange way, a strange way to say.
The angels who visited Mary and Joseph told them both that the baby's name would be Jesus. Matthew 1, verse 20 and 21, Luke 1, verse 30 to 31. His name indicated that the baby would save his people from their sins. If Christ had not come, there would be no forgiveness. There would be no compassion. Hope would be gone. We would be bound in sin, and our search for peace would be futile. There is no other name that saves, as Acts 4, verse 12 tells us. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Rejoice, for we are no longer bound by the laws of sin and flesh, but we live in grace and peace forever.
said, be not afraid, for born on this day, born to save, is Christ the Lord. Shepherds watch by night, when an angel appeared from on high, and said, be not afraid, for born on this day, born to save, is Christ the Lord.
Right from the beginning, God's love has reached, and from the beginning, man has refused to understand. But love went on reaching, offering itself. Love offered the external. We wanted the immediate. Love offered deep joy. We wanted thrills. Love offered freedom. We wanted license. Love offered communion with God Himself. We wanted to worship at the shrine of our own minds. Love offered peace. We wanted approval for our wars. Even so, love went on reaching.
Starry night, so bright, the world was filled with love, wonderful sight, the light.
John 4:15 to 19. If we declare that Jesus is the Son of God, we live in union with God, and God lives in union with us. And we ourselves know and believe the love which God has for us. God is love. And those who live in love live in union with God, and God lives in union with them. Love is made perfect in us in order that we may have courage on the judgment day, and we will have it because our lives in this world is the same as Christ's. There is no fear in love. Perfect love drives out all fear. So then, love has not been made perfect in anyone who is afraid, because fear has to do with punishment. We love because God first loved us. The word of the Lord.
Good evening, my brothers and sisters. Love came down. In 1 John chapter 4, verses 15 to 19, we can see clearly that God's love is meant to be reciprocated by those who receive it. And in the Gospel of St. John chapter 3, verse 16, which is a very familiar passage to most of us, states how God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. And in 1 John 4, verse 15, the scripture tells us that, if anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, and God lives in them and they live in him. That is NIV version. First things first, if you do not acknowledge Jesus Christ as the Son of God, then God does not live in you, because Jesus is the one that connects us to God the Father. He is the only way to the Father, and no one says that they know God without acknowledging his Son. Secondly, if God does not live in you and I, then there is no way we can abide in love, because God is love, and whoever lives in love lives in God and God in them. You and I cannot be able to produce fruit if we are not connected to the source. Love is the fruit of the Spirit, so it is made possible for us not just to love, but also to abide in love. What then does it mean to abide in love? It means that we must remain in love and continue to love even when it seems impossible. To love continually. Some people may love you today and hurt you tomorrow because they do not have the Spirit of God in them. Therefore, the love we are talking about is that which came down from heaven, love incarnate. This is the love of God the Father towards his children, of which you and I are a part. This is the love of God through his Son, Jesus Christ. God sent him down from heaven to be able to come down here on earth, and that he should die so that we could be saved from our sins. What is your response then to this gift from heaven? How have you received this gift, and what difference has it made in your life? Do you have Jesus living in your heart today? If so, what impact or difference are you making in this world today? If you have not done that so, I encourage you to consider making that decision when you have time, for tomorrow might be too late. The last part of verse 17 says, in this world, we are like Jesus. And I like how the contemporary English version puts it, that if we truly love others and live as Christ did in this world, we won't be able to be worried about Judgment Day. As we go about our day-to-day business, brothers and sisters, we should always have that at the back of our minds, that Judgment Day is coming, and whatever we do or say shall be accounted for during that time. How then are we representing the love of God to the people of this world, my brothers and sisters? Jesus came to save the lost. He came to heal the sick, to bind up the brokenhearted, and to set the captives free. Let us therefore be the instruments of change in this broken and sick world, my brothers and sisters. There are so many souls that have been lost. Many lives have become slaves to sin. Jesus has saved you and I, so we could go and bring many others who are still wandering about, not knowing who to run to or where to turn to in these perilous times. Friends, we love because God first loved us. You need to experience this kind of love before you could love others. Love is from God, and only he can make us to love others. Have you been searching for love and you don't seem to find it? Try this kind of love, which came down from heaven, and you will find true meaning to love. Jesus is real, and he is the reason for our existence. Let us therefore remember that as we celebrate this Advent period, Jesus is the reason for the season. Wishing you all a blessed Christmas.
And still, after 2,000 years, patiently, lovingly, Christ is reaching out to us today, right through the chaos of our world, through the confusion of our minds. He is reaching, longing to share with us the very being of God. His love still is longing. His love is still reaching right past the shackles of our mind. And the word of the Father became Mary's little son, and his love reached all the way to where we are.
Love came down at Christmas. Savior is born. Love came down at Christmas, singing praises to our kings. Above all names, in glorious majesty, let us worship together the newborn King. Sing love.
Brothers and sisters, it has indeed been our pleasure to share with you in this our first virtual Christmas concert. Before we depart from this virtual space, allow me to say thanks to all participants, all persons who made this production possible, our friends who partnered with us, who prepared with us, and presented this, our gift to you, in this Advent season. To you, our viewers, had you not been with us, all this effort would be to naught. And so a very special thank you is extended to all who viewed, all who shared, all who commented, all who supported this venture. We invite those who are able to, within the confines of your home, to stand as we share in the benediction. People of God, having been reminded of God's love, having reflected on how applicable this love is to us, now let us go forth with a mission to share this love. And as we do so, may grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. As we bring this program to a close, we will have an item by our sister Sarah Timbawala. Have yourself a merry little Christmas.